Yo, what's up?
This is Patrick from Guiding the Cube. Lots of people are talking about Direct Lake and they want to kick the tires on it, but people are struggling because they're like, well, how do I get my import model that I built over to Direct Lake? Do I have to rebuild it? What if I have incremental refresh? What if I have composite models? Somewhat complex models. How do I get those over to Direct Lake to see how they perform against my existing model today? It can be a challenge. Well, no problem. Michael Kowalski extended Senpai to help us do some migration from these models, import, you know, direct query to a Direct Lake model. It makes it really easy. And in this video, I kind of, you know, put it through the ringer a little bit to see what it can do. So, you know how we like to do? Enough of all this talking. Let's try out this Semantic Link Labs from Michael Kowalski. Let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So the first thing you want to do, create your workspace, get your model deployed out. Here's my model. I have some custom partitions. I'll show you what this model looks like in a little bit, and create your lake house. Once your lake house is created, go out to Elegant BI, that's Michael's blog, and click on Direct Lake Migration. And he's got a really good article that he's published a while ago. I'm kind of behind on this. And what Michael has done is he's wrapped some of those APIs that does all these things like rebinding reports into Python using Semantic Link Lab to make this migration really easy process. And that's not the only thing that Semantic Link Labs can do. That's what I'm focusing on in this video. If you go through Semantic Link Labs and you see some other things that you're interested in, and you would like me to do a video on it, you know what to do. Post it in the comments below. All right, read through the article. It's a really good article. But what you want to do is simply click on this link, because you'll need this notebook to do the migration. When you click on this link, it'll take you to the Semantic Links Lab Git repo. And all you need to do is download. Head back to your workspace, and then you should see your lake house created, the lake house, the default semantic model, and the SQL analytics endpoint. And then you'll see your semantic model. When I published the model out, I immediately did a refresh of my model just to get everything. I'm not sure if that was a requirement, but I did, just to be sure, just to be cautious. For this one, I had to use Tabular Editor 2 or 3 because I wanted to add some custom partitions here. So you can see I have created some partitions against the internet sales table, right? And if I go to Management Studio, you can see if I go connect to that model, right click here, go to partitions, you'll see all the partitions for that particular table. So you can see how many rows are in each one of those partitions. And right now it's import. Well, I want to migrate it over to Direct Lake to see how it performs compared to the import model that I have. This is just a sample. I was trying to make some custom partitions. You can make days, months, years, however you want to partition it. I do have one that I did with incremental refresh that had multiple yearly partition that I migrated. And I'll show you that one. And there's a little caveat, something you need to do. So once all this is done, you go back over to your workspace, and Adam's going to roll his eyes when I say this. Today, if you want to import a notebook from your local machine, you need to switch personas from Power BI to Data Engineering. Let me show you. So if I go to Power BI and I go to my workspace, I can choose upload, but you don't see a notebook. If I switch this over to Data Engineering or the others, I haven't tried the other ones, and go to my workspace and I choose import, I can choose notebook from my local computer. So the one I downloaded, I'm gonna click it, get it opened up, it's imported, go here. And the first thing I'm gonna do when I get this is I'm gonna attach this to my lake house. Make sure you choose the right one, okay? Click add, that's the one I want. There we go. There's nothing in this one. The first thing you need to do is install Semantic Links Lab. This could take a little bit. So I'm going to go ahead and press play here. I've seen it take up to a minute to install. Once that's installed, you need to do a few things. Right here, you need to set the dataset name, the dataset that you publish, and then what you want the new dataset name to be. So I'm going to head back to my workspace just because I don't remember it. Get it on my clipboard. Go over here, paste the dataset name in, and then paste it right here for my new data set name, and then say Direct Lake. Now, do not name your lake house the exact same name as the model that you're publishing, because it creates that default semantic model. So you'll have two models with the exact same name, and you could run into some challenges there. So don't do that. Once you get that done, run this. This is going to import the library and set some initial parameters. If you want to do this in a different workspace, if you want to publish the new model to a different workspace, if you have multiple lake houses in that workspace, you need to specify those. For me, I just have a single lake house and I'm just using all the default parameters. So once that's done, we're going to run this code block, and this is actually going to create a Power Query template of my semantic model, the original semantic model. It's really, really cool. I think Michael said he worked with Alex Powers. Big shout out to everybody that helped with this. So we're going to run this. So we run this. Boom, it's done. When it's done, what it does is, and this is why you need to connect your notebook to this particular lake house, because what it's gonna do is, it's actually gonna create a PQT file, which is a template file for Power Query. And so you can see it right there. And now what I'm gonna do within the context of the lake house, I'm gonna go here, open up my lake house. Make sure you're in the lake house, okay, that you want your objects to be created in. Choose get data and choose new data flows gen 2. It's gonna open up. There we go. And then what you want to do right here, click import from Power Query template. Click that. And then you need to have OneLake Explorer running. Right click on it and choose sync from OneLake. And then in a few short seconds, you'll see here's my new DirectLake workspace that I created. If I click right here, go into it, go into the file section, you'll see Power Query template. You could do this all from the File Explorer. I just like how easy it is to do it while I'm browsing, while I'm trying to open it. So I'm just syncing, so I don't have to leave the context of Fabric. So I'm gonna choose that Power Query template and click open. And it's gonna load up all of the Power Query that I needed to build out my semantic model. And now all I need to do now is configure my connection. Now you need to make sure this connection has been created out in your data sources under the connection under the admin portal. Click connect, and then you'll see all of my tables start to appear. Boom, 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 boom. Once all the little warning signs go away and all my data is ready to go, that's it. If you don't see this destination right here, you've done something wrong. But if you hover, you can see this is going to my lake house, and this is the workspace that is in. So once I click publish, it's gonna close this data flow, and it's gonna start to publish this data flow out to my workspace. And then you'll see the little spinny here. And then when the publishing is complete, you'll see the refresh start. And it's actually taking that data from the source and bringing it down into my lake house. Another thing I wanna point out is, if this works for you and you like it and it's performant and it's everything you knew and hoped that direct lake would be, while this process will continue to pull the data into the lake house, if you already have a lake house or if you already have a warehouse in your environment, you may want to consider changing the ETL process to go directly to Fabric as opposed to loading that external source, because now you're making multiple copies. So now that the data flow is complete, if I go back into my lake house, it's great, click refresh, you'll see everything I need to build out my model is in my lake house. Then I go back to my notebook, and the next part is to run this script, which is actually gonna create my semantic model for me. So I'm gonna go ahead and run this. It takes a little bit to go through all the steps and all the processes for the entire refresh to complete, but just like that, it's done. If we go over to my workspace, you'll see the new semantic model here. I'm gonna go and open my data model up. You'll see my data model is created. You can see my measures here, the two tables. You can see that my calc group is created. Even my calculated table was migrated. It can't create calculated columns. It won't do that because calculated columns aren't supported in DirectLake. Calculated tables that depend on data in the import model can't be recreated, but my calendar table, I was hard coding the date, so it didn't depend on any data, so it migrated it over successfully. It also migrated over my field parameter and my hierarchy, which is pretty cool. So let's see if I can create a report. So we'll go here and let's see if there's some data in this. Let's bring over total quantity. Boom, there's my data. I can, let's go to my calendar and look at this by year. There we go, right? It's pretty fast and it works. So the migration was successful. It took a little bit to go through the migration process, but most of the times it works. Sometimes I have to refresh the model because I got this error one time saying it couldn't find it, and I just went refresh the model and I reran it again and it did the migration for me. Now, for most of the models, you don't have to do anything. One I did that was a composite model, let me show you. And so I have a composite model workspace here. And so we'll go to the notebook that I walked through, and you'll see I just did the install, set the name, get the Power Query template file, and then you can see it did all the migration for me. So it all just worked. Now, the one that I had to go and kind of tinker with a little bit was incremental refresh. I go to my workspace, where the one where I did incremental refresh. So when I initially did the refresh, the data flow actually brought in the filter on the table where I set up incremental refresh. So on my internet sales table, if you right click, you can set up incremental refresh. But because when you walk through this and it creates the PQT file for you, it lands the tables in a lake house. Because that destination is there, you can't set up incremental refresh. But if you're using Direct Lake, you don't need incremental refresh. You can dump all the data. You set up your process to incrementally load your lake house, not incrementally populate your Direct Lake semantic model. And if you're unsure of Direct Lake semantic models, I have a couple of videos. You should go check them out. But what I had to do was just to ensure that it brought all the data in, I went on internet sales, and the step that I used to apply my custom parameters, my built system parameters for incremental refresh, I just deleted that step before I did the publish and the refresh, and it brought all my data in. And once I did that, I can go to the notebook for incremental refresh. And you can see, same steps, very similar. I did the same thing. Only thing I changed was the name, provided the data set name, and gave the new data set a new name. Did the PQT file and did my migration, and it migrated everything over. Long process, one of my longer videos, but I was really excited to kick the tires on this. Again, thank you, Michael, and everyone else that contributed to this. You should go and try this out. Kick the tires on Direct Lake. Do some migrations. Let us know. Let us know what you find. We'd love to know what challenges you run into. Like I said, I ran into a few. If you have any questions, comments, you know what to do. Post them in the comments below. If you want to learn more about Fabric, the workloads in Fabric, there's probably a video flying above my head. And as always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.